Okay, so 5 months, 300 grand, and what have you got to show for it? Nothing, other than the recommendation you actually had in July, and a request for another 600. I don't see any external advice or any external input in this report. I don't see any impartiality. What I do see is a biased, contrived report. There are some sneaky tricks in it, like saying you haven't used optimism bias, which has been widely criticised for its misuse, but then you show a range of figures which include optimism bias. I think it's trying to terrify people. And it's a classic misdirection technique. Listing benefits are not agreeable. There's another trick, showing a single resident in Barnet who thinks that planning and planning enforcement is better than it was before it was outsourced. Or that people think they can get through the automated switchboard. Because they can't. The report makes much of the risks of an in-house team not achieving income or performance targets. It fails to recognise Capita have failed to meet income targets and have delivered poor performance over the last 5 years. In next week's financial performance and contracts committee papers, it highlights a shortfall of 1.3 million of unachievable income from CSG and 1.16 million shortfall of income from RIG. Why is that recognised? In terms of poor performance, that's not me saying poor performance. It's your senior managers who said it last year. And that's why Capita were building huge hundreds of thousands of pounds in service credits. Now, you prioritise finance and strategic HR and you brought back in-house by the end of March. The big problem is that newly insourced in-house finance team will be stuck using Integrate with all the data on Capita service dispersed throughout the country. Now that represents a major risk, and also it undermines the effectiveness of the in-house team. The report notes that you will have to negotiate support levels for the integrated system as part of the transition plan. Look, at this stage, at some stage, you're going to have to migrate that data back to Barnet to either do it now, with 5 years' time when the contract expires, or sooner if Capita go bust. You scheduled IT for review in phase four, which makes no sense whatsoever. It's inextricably linked to finance. You're also comparing like-for-like services run by Capita or an identical service run in-house. What you overlook is the opportunity to restructure the council, make it much more integrated, flexible, and agile workforce, and to cut out a huge number of commissioning management posts. This is a bad and biased report. I've got no confidence. Any decisions based on it will be flawed and it could cost this authority even more money.
Thank you.